Hey everyone. Today I wanted to showcase one of the most fun ways, in my opinion, to make a lot of money quickly in Hunt Showdown. I see comments all the time about the game's economy, where like sweaty veteran players kind of have an unlimited supply of money, and they can just take whatever loadout they want every single game, and newer or junior players just kind of have a hard time keeping up. It almost creates this cycle where the more broke players have to take free hunters and free loadouts that are less strong, and then face them off against teams with stronger, more meta loadouts, and so they don't do as well, and then so on. We've all seen the basic tips about making money in the game. Take a free hunter, make sure you get all the clues, locations of cash registers, but then you just go about playing the game, and you're still stuck with your weak loadout trying to win. With this strategy, it doesn't really matter what loadout you take, because you're going to do everything you can to avoid fighting in the first place. It's also especially nice in the latest Tide of Shadows event with the introduction of Death Cheat. But moreover, the fact that you get an extra 500 hunt dollars when you get a hunter to level 50 is really great. All you really need for this strategy is Magpie and Serpent, but you can make it a little stronger with things like Conduit, Gator Legs, and Necromancer if you end up getting caught. I think it goes without saying, but if you want to maximize the profit, you should be doing this with a free hunter and one that's going to benefit from the 20% boost to hunt dollars that you earn in the mission. Anyway, instead of talking anymore, I want to just show you. So here's a montage of me doing it 10 times to Bon Jovi's Runaway. And stay to the end if you want to see how much money I made overall.
Should have seen it in your eyes.
All right, I hope you guys enjoyed that. All in all, after 10 games, I made about 17.5K, and I only got caught and killed a single time when I was trying to get the footage for this. The only other times that it didn't work was when the enemy would pick up both bounties immediately when they dropped, but every other time I made it out with my life and a few thousand hunt dollars even when they chased me. I think this strategy kind of trumps all others in terms of making money because you get to set the pace when it comes to ending the game, and it's also just kind of fun ratting around and hoping you can get away with it. Anyway, if you liked the video, please consider subscribing and checking out some of my other fun videos, and I hope you guys have a good one. Thanks for watching.